Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. The Criteria Builder provides a method for each database function supported by the JPA standard. But what about all the functions that are database specific or user defined? You can use these functions as well, and in this video I will show you how. Since JPA 2.1, you can use the function method of the Criteria Builder to call user-defined or database-specific functions. You need to provide the name and the expected result type of the function as the first two parameters, and you can provide one or more expressions which will be used as function arguments. You can use this approach in the WHERE clause to call all functions supported by your database. You can also use it in the SELECT clause of your query, but you then need to register the database function so that Hibernate knows its result type. Here you can see an example that calls the custom database function CALCULATE in the WHERE clause. The query is pretty simple. It uses the CALCULATE function to add the value of a query parameter to the price of the book and compares the result with a second query parameter. If the second parameter is higher than the result of the database function, it returns the book entity. Okay, so how do you define such a query? I first get the Criteria Builder and use it to create a criteria query that returns a book entity. Before I define the WHERE clause, I need two parameters of type double. Then I use the function method of the Criteria Builder to call the database function CALCULATE with the price of the book and the first query parameter. I use the result of this function in the WHERE clause and compare it with the second query parameter. Let's run this test and take a look at the generated SQA statement. As you can see here, Hibernate generated a query that calls the CALCULATE function in the WHERE clause. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!